Have been to Saudi Arabia recently. Now, I'm very respectful of laws. The law is in Saudi Arabia, no Jew enters, and I'm a Jew. I am Jewish, my wife is Jewish too. And the law is no Jew is allowed to enter. And another law, no Christian pastor is allowed to preach there, to come there to preach. And I'm a Christian pastor. And I have to respect the law. The law does not say about a Jew who is a Christian pastor. That's a combination. The law does not say that he is forbidden to enter. That was a special case, you know. And so I could enter. They have a very strict law. No Bible. One Bible is not allowed to enter Saudi Arabia. Not one Bible can enter there. There are engineers who work in oil companies and so on. When they come there, they have to leave the Bible at the custom. When they leave, the Bible is given back to them. They are not allowed to have a Bible with them. And I'm very respectful of laws, and our mission respects laws. What kind of a Christian mission if we don't respect laws? If the law is you don't have the right to bring one Bible, we did not bring one. We brought 30,000. The law says nothing about 30,000. But we succeeded to smuggle them in. The top smuggler will be here tomorrow. He did not arrive yet. So 30,000 Bibles entered. Now, as I have so many directors of mission here, they expect me, well, you preach all right, Burman, but you forget to say about our mission, which is also very important. Be practical, not say about our mission something. We are a mission, Voice of the Martyrs. Our director, Tom White, is a member of your church. You know probably about our mission. Those who don't know, leave your name and address at the table with books there. You will get regularly from us our newsletter for free. We try to help as best we can Christians persecuted, be it in Muslim countries, be it in communist or in former communist countries. We do this work. We smuggle in Bibles, Christian literature. Where we can, we smuggle in printing machines. These also can be smuggled in. We give help to families of Christians who are in jail. You will have a good dinner now. Children of Christians who died for Christ don't have a dinner. And they need it, and their elderly parents, in the measure in which we can, we help these. And I hope you will help this mission, you will help these persecuted Christians, and you do well to help. But I believe that this persecuted church can help us in the West much more than we can help them. We can help with a few coins, we can help with a few dollars, we can help with big bills, we can give a great check. And that's also a sacrifice for God. You take it from yourself and from your family and so on. But they give their lives, they give their liberty. And not only that they give it, but like this John who ate ding, the face shines and you sing. And somehow, this shining faces and the smile and the victory, his victory, somehow it contaminates us too. These are my brethren.